Hello Primary 4, how are you today? I'm Ms. Sarah, I'm teaching science, and today we're going to talk about digestive system. As you know, Primary 4, all living organism or all living things need three to live, which are food, water, and air. So all living things need food, water, and air to live. But where does the food that you eat go, Primary 4? Before we know that, you should know that in your body you have different types of organs. You have different types of organs, like those organs, Primary 4. You can see here the two lungs, and you can see here the heart, and you can see the stomach and liver and small and large intestine. The lungs are organs, and the heart is an organ, and stomach is an organ, and also liver is an organ. And small intestine and large intestine are also organs. So in your body you can find different types of organs. Each group of organs, Primary 4, form a system like this system, Primary 4. We can find here different types of organs that form a system which is called digestive system. You can find here the mouth, the throat or the pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine and large intestine, and anus opening. Those are the organs of digestive system. So living things as a human or animals consist of systems, and each system consists of group of organs. So this is the human digestive system, Primary 4. Start with mouth and end with anus opening. Those are different types of organs that form the human digestive system. Let's talk about each organ, Primary 4. The first organ that we have is the mouth, Primary 4. This is the mouth. What can you find in your mouth, Primary 4? You can find teeth, right? You can find tongue, and you can find saliva, which is the liquid in your mouth. So in your mouth you can find teeth, tongue, and also the saliva. So what is the importance of each part in your mouth, Primary 4? As you can see here, the eating the food, right? This is the chewing process, Primary 4. When you crush the food with your teeth, this is the chewing process. So teeth crush the food during the chewing process. How about the saliva? We said that the saliva is the liquid in your mouth, Primary 4, which is moisten the food, soften the food, make the food softer and moister. Why? To break it down easily into smaller parts. So the role or the importance or the function of the saliva, that it is a liquid in your mouth that soften or moisten the food to break it down easily into smaller parts. How about the tongue? We said that in your mouth you can find tongue also. Tongue mixes the food with saliva. So in your mouth you can find teeth that crushes the food during chewing process, and you can find saliva, that is the liquid in your mouth which moistens the food to break it down easily, and you can find tongue, which is mixes the food with the saliva. The second organ, Primary 4, is called pharynx or throat. This is the pharynx or throat, Primary 4. It comes after the mouth. And end with the next organs, which is esophagus. So throat or pharynx connect between the mouth and the esophagus, Primary 4. So the next organ is esophagus, Primary 4. This is called esophagus. So when you swallow the food that you eat, Primary 4, in your neck, this part in your neck is called esophagus. What is the role or the function of the esophagus, Primary 4? Esophagus is a muscular tube. When I say muscular tube, that means this tube is made of muscles, So esophagus is a long muscular tube that pushes the food to the next organ, which is stomach. So esophagus connect between the throat or the pharynx with the stomach. It is a long muscular tube that pushes the food to the stomach. Super. So the next organ, Primary 4, is called stomach. This is your stomach, Primary 4. You can find a liquid in your stomach, right? This liquid is called stomach acid and enzymes. What is the importance of stomach acid and enzymes, Primary 4? When the food that you eat is mixed with those acid and enzymes, the food that you eat turns into soupy liquid, So the importance of stomach acid and the enzyme, that it turns the food that you eat into soupy liquid. But this process takes about few hours primary for till the food becomes soupy liquid. So what happens in the stomach? In the stomach, the food is mixed with the stomach acids and enzymes. And digestion that happens in the stomach takes about few hours till the food becomes soupy liquid. But what about digestion? What is the meaning of digestion process primary four? So digestion process primary four, it is the process of breaking down food and changing it into chemical substance, which are nutrients that the body absorbs and uses them in getting energy and growth. So when I say it is the process of breaking down food, when you eat the food, it becomes smaller part in your mouth, right? This is the breakdown of food. And then it goes to the stomach to become soupy liquid, and it changing also into smaller part. When it comes to the smallest part, this is called chemical substance or nutrients. So nutrients or the chemical substance are the simplest form or the smallest part of the food that you eat, okay, that the body absorbs. So what is the meaning of absorbs primary form? Like when you have spilled milk on the floor primary four, you will use a tissue to take this milk from the floor or to absorb this milk from the floor by the tissue. This is the meaning of absorb, so to take it and uses them in getting energy and growth. So we use the food that we eat when it becomes a nutrients to get energy and growth. So digestion process, it is the process of breaking down food and changing it into chemical substance, which are nutrients. Super. That is the body absorbs and uses them in getting energy and growth. The next organ primary four is called small intestine. So after the stomach, we have small intestine. So this is the small intestine primary four. As you can see here, primary four, it is a tube, right? A long tube, and also it takes a spiral shape. So small intestine is a long winding tube or a spiral tube. As you can see, it is a long tube. The length of this tube, small intestine, is more than 6 meters long. Can you imagine? The length of the small intestine is more than 6 meters long. What happens in the small intestine primary four? We said that the soupy liquid that formed in the stomach, it will go to the small intestine. The digestion process that happens in the small intestine, it will make the food or the soupy liquid to break down into the simplest part or the nutrients, the chemical substance, in the presence of pancreas and liver juices. So the liver and pancreas will put their juices in the small intestine to break down the soupy liquid that is formed in the stomach into the simplest part, which is the nutrients or the chemical substance. So what will happen primary four when the soupy liquid that is formed in the stomach is breaking down into the simplest part, which is the nutrients? Those nutrients will be absorbed through the wall of the small intestine. So you find here the walls of the small intestine. Those walls will absorb those nutrients and give it to the tiny blood vessels to give it to all body parts. So what happens in the small intestine? Soupy liquid is broken into the simplest nutrients or the chemical substance in presence of super pancreas and liver juices. And then the nutrients are absorbed through the wall of small intestine to super tiny blood vessels to all body parts. So the next organ after small intestine, we have large intestine. This is the large intestine primary four. What happens in the large intestine primary four? When digestion process happens and the food becomes nutrients or the simplest form, some of the foods that we eat is undigested, or it becomes waste material. Those waste material go to the large intestine to store those undigested food. But what happens to those undigested food material or those waste material? Large intestine takes the water from them, take the water from the undigested food to become solid. So this undigested food material or the waste material becomes solid. As you can see here, the food here or undigested food material, the water is taken from it and becomes solid. When it becomes solid, it becomes stool. We call it stool. So the body gets rid of this stool through the anus opening, the last organ in the digestive system. As you can see here, this is the anus opening. So undigested food materials go to the large intestine and water is reabsorbed or taken from it. So it becomes solid, and when it becomes solid, we call it stool. And then the body gets rid of this stool through the anus opening. So what is the meaning of digestive system primary food? Digestive system, it is the system that's responsible for breaking down food into smallest part, which is nutrients, to enable the body cells to use them to get energy. So we get energy when the food becomes nutrients and it goes to all body part. The cell uses this nutrients to get energy. Super. So the energy that you get, we use it for different activities. Primary food, the energy is needed for different activities. So the organs of the human digestive system start with mouth, super, then we have throat or pharynx, then we have esophagus, then we have here stomach, and we have here liver, and the yellow one is the pancreas, then we have a small intestine, then large intestine, and end with anus opening. Super. This was our lesson for today. I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Goodbye.